there was one big one called the Firemen of Alijo, which now belonged to the Tate Gallery. And that picture, we went that Christmas, we went to spend New Year's Eve up in the north of Portugal in a town called Alijo, which is very, very cold, and it was snowing. And we were staying in a pousada, a very small hotel. Vic, my mother, my father, just us, the children that stayed behind. And it was dismal. It was a dismal, sad, cold place. And we went outside and we saw the chaps, men standing there, dressed in straw. That's how they dressed. To keep warm, they dressed in straw. Traditional costume, but they still had it. Keep them warm. And in the snow with bare feet. And they're all standing outside the station, just at the fire station, and somewhere outside the tavern. And the firemen were coming out, there'd been some accident or something. And I was just horrified to see this poverty and everything. It was a very uncomfortable experience, not just from seeing this poverty, but also from the uncomfortableness of the hotel, and also my father not being well already. The grim reaper was already smelling around there somewhere, that's for sure. And I came back to London and I did that picture, the Firemen of Alijo. Yeah, that was actually shown at the London Group, because I'd been made a member by Claude Rogers, who was wonderful, actually. And his wife, Elsie Few, bought it for some collection she was making, which ended up at Kingston College, you know? And it was discovered years later, disappeared, you know, years later down there in a cellar somewhere, and they hung it up on the wall, and then bought it, which was good. It was quite a nice picture. That was the last picture of that lot. After that, it was general decline for years, that's what it was. Just lost for years, because my father died and all those things happened.